Hello, and welcome to today's video where I'll be covering my webcomic process in Clip Studio Paint. Today we'll be discussing reference layers and how they can be used to make your webcomic process easier. Links to additional tutorials and information about anything mentioned in today's video will be down in the description box below. Have you ever been in a situation where you're trying to color in line art of your character, but accidentally keep coloring in the background as well? Or have you ever tried to color something in with a fill bucket, only for it to leave little white gaps behind? I find that before using Clip Studio Paint, I often had to approach coloring in one of two ways. Either I could do it quickly and have it look messy, or I could have it look perfect but spend a lot of time on it. Fortunately, Clip Studio Paint has a feature that completely changes the way I approach coloring my webcomics, known as a reference layer. So how does it work? In essence, the reference layer is a type of layer that gives instructions to your tools when you use them together. For example, setting your line art layer as reference will keep your colors from going outside the lines, or will make sure white gaps never appear. Combining this with Clip Studio Paint's many other tools is a great way to speed up what would otherwise be a really time-consuming process. You can set any layer as the reference layer by selecting it, then clicking this lighthouse button here on the Layers panel. The same symbol will appear next to the layer once it's been applied. Now, it may not seem like anything has happened yet. This is because using reference layers requires some adjustment to your tools for it to work. For this example, we'll pick this Enclose and Fill Lasso as our tool of choice. To make it follow the instructions of the reference layer, go to the Subtool Detail panel and open the Reference menu. Check the Refer Multiple box, then find the lighthouse symbol we mentioned earlier and select it. This will instruct the lasso to always obey the instructions of the reference layer. Now let's test it out. On my top layer, I have my character line art, which is set as reference. My middle layer is for my colors, where I'll be using the Enclose and Fill Lasso tool. Finally, on the last layer, I've drawn some additional line art that overlaps with my character line art. Normally, coloring something like this would be a pain, as I'd have to carefully fill in the character line art while going around the other line art. Thanks to my reference layer and Fill Lasso, though, I can select my color layer, encircle my character line art, and instantly it'll fill just the lines I want filled. And as you can see by toggling off the line art, the lines were perfectly filled right up to the edge, leaving no white gaps. You can further adjust how the fill scales with your line art in the closed area fill menu of the Subtool Detail panel. There are a few different coloring tools besides the Fill Lasso that are compatible with reference layers. The Fill Bucket is a common choice for reference layers. Like the lasso, this is useful when trying to color only certain line art while ignoring others. The Paint Unfilled Area Selection Pen is another good choice. This tool lets you draw over an area and then fills in any open gaps it finds. This is normally handy for filling in white spots left from manual coloring and filling. With it set to refer to reference layers at low tolerance, however, it'll interpret any open spots in your line art as an unfilled area, meaning you can quickly swipe over your line art and fill it in perfectly. If you want to fill in an area with a pattern or image material, you can also use reference layer settings on your selection tool to make selections inside of your line art. The Selection for Referred Layers tool has these settings by default. Once you've selected your area of choice, it's as easy as dragging and dropping in a material from your library or clicking the Paste button at the bottom of the panel, and your selection will be filled in right away. Finally, any brush can be set to refer to the reference layer. This is ideal if you have a specific texture or effect in mind, or just like coloring things in by hand. Go to the Subtool Detail panel and find the Anti-Overflow menu, then check off the Do Not Cross Lines of Reference Layer box. Now you can color in any section of the line art by hand, and it'll automatically stay inside the lines. Beyond just solid filling, there are some unique effects you could achieve using reference layers when coloring. One of my favorites is creating rainbow patches of color under patterned line art. For this example, I've put down a scale pattern I want to fill in. I could just fill this in with a lasso or bucket tool, but I want to give these colors some variety and make the scale stand out. So instead, I'm going to pick a brush with some color effects. You could use color jitter, color mixing, or any combination of settings that affect your output color. Then, using a large brush size, I'll start coloring in the area. As you can see, each scale is filled in with its own unique color, and the colors will change the more you draw. A similar effect can be achieved using a texture brush. By going over the scales with a large brush, each scale will be filled in with a different area of the texture, which will make the scale stand out and feel more unique. These effects can be combined with color adjustment layers like a gradient map to easily give your work some variety while still using a cohesive color palette. This technique would be really useful for coloring leaves on trees, gemstones, and patterned clothing, and I'm sure you could think of plenty more applications for your own project. Those are the basics of how I use reference layers to make my webcomic process easier in Clip Studio Paint. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.